August 8th, 2015. Looking at these peppers out here, they may not look very big to a lot of people. They're about 18 inches tall. You got some, you got a bunch of little baby parts on it. You can see down there by the cane, that pepper. Again, I can't see on the viewfinder for crap. What is this? I swear, right down there is a pepper. You can see it's like a long pointed one. I can't remember the type. Look at the little, see, we have all kinds of wildlife out here. Anyway, this is cracked viewfinder. I can't really zoom in tight to show you a lot. This is, I think, is a habanero pepper, the little one down there. Bell peppers, that one pepper, I don't know what it is. But look at the pepper plants in the back there. They're so tall, but there's no, I don't see no flowers or no peppers on them at all yet. This one here, no flowers. These are pepper plants now. That one, this one here too. And the one in the back there. All three of those are the same type. No peppers yet. We tore up some stuff because of the disease out here, the brown spot, and it stopped producing. The tomatoes here, the ones from Kmart, they said they were heirlooms. That's why the only reason I bought them, I didn't really want to buy a store-bought heirloom plant, but I did. They almost look like they're decimated with the brown spot. Look at that. And I blame that for anything. Look at our plants. This is a real big one here. The first one I put out here was so small, and look at how big and full it is. We've already had fried green tomatoes off of this first one. You can see how big they are. They're giant. It's almost the size of a softball. What is that now, right there? There's a red one there. It's just turning red now. Some on the second one, too. That came from in the house, too. And then we got pepper plants there. You can see the long peppers on them. Another bell pepper, if I can get it on the viewfinder there. I see it's underneath the crack, that's why I can see it. And in the back we got those, I think those are pimento peppers. They're red already. But see, there's, look at the third tomato plant from Kmart. Look at that one, it's almost dead. It's got a flower on it, but I'm not messing with it. We took one off of here, I took one off of here, I should say, yesterday or the day before. Cut open, there was one seed in there. So then I thought to myself, maybe these are not heirloom. Maybe these are hybrid that some asshole put on the shelf. Or maybe that's what Kmart put out there. That's why I don't like buying shit from the store that says they're heirloom. I trust an heirloom dealer because they've been in business for that and they wouldn't dare not sell you heirloom. Everything out here is from seed, except for these four tomato plants here from Kmart. So if we did another one of these red tomatoes out there and we cut it open, there's only one seed or no seeds, then I'm going to rip up all four of these, even with that stuff on them. I'm not eating that crap. See, here's a tomato plant. It's bigger than the first one I put out here. The bean plants got brown spot or whatever. They're no good now. Ripped up the pumpkin, because, you know, they were getting all diseased now. Those are all no good, all those pumpkins. Purple pole bean coming out again because one bean was replanted about 3 weeks ago. Squash over here. There's my Jackson Wonder bean, and then there's two right there too. Those are looking really nice over there. They're spreading out. But the squash plants, you look on here, you'll see eggs. The eggs right there for squash bugs. I sprayed them yesterday with the soap. I use a bar of ivory soap inside that gallon of water and let it dissolve inside there. About half a bar, I should say. And spray on there. It kills them off. Now, I don't know about the eggs, but all the insects it's killing off, because look at the zucchini out here. It's totally decimated just about. I sprayed these yesterday and they were running all over the place. They go underneath here. Look at, but you see the flowers? The flowers are coming back. They weren't on here for a couple days. There's one in the back there. See the flowers? That needs to be pollinated to get more any squash off of them. Zucchini, I'm sorry. Zucchini. See, these are going to be ripped up here. It's going to be real hot today. So I'm not going to rip this up today. It's Saturday. But I sprayed all this really good with the soap because of the disease on it. This is a purple hull bean, and those in the back there are purple hull beans. The rest are black-eyed peas. Look at how that looks. Everything came out, everything blew up, but then you get these diseases and insects on them. And look, let me see if I can get a close-up on that one pod. I don't know if you really see it. It almost looks like a cluster of ants or something, but it's just bumps, it's eggs, like. Sprayed the crap out of this today, yesterday too. So, these are purple hull peas. These are extremely good, hard to find too. But look at this, see, you can see it on here. See all the bumps on there? It looks like sugar on a piece of candy or something. But it's eggs and whatnot. So next year, now we know how this is all gonna come out. This is all gonna be separated more. I dropped 4 purple hull peas in those holes all the way back there. Not thinking they would grow because they weren't even really matured. But look, we got one right there growing up here. So you can see my foot next to how big it is. Got one right there growing up. One growing up right there. And that one there, it looks like it's getting all messed up where Petey's at. Get away from there, Petey. I sprayed them yesterday, though, really good. I soaked them with the soapy water, which is supposed to help with the disease. Actually, no. Soapy water is for insects. Baking soda water is for disease. I may have sprayed this a couple days back, too, because... all this is just getting me so aggravated. There's some more black-eyed pea pods to pick right down there. I just had some the other day. We've had purple hull peas from out here. Oh, they're good. Yeah, look how fresh these look now, too. Look how they're springing up. I sprayed all this yesterday with the soap water mix to get the insects. But look at that. That's up above. Oh, look. See right there? That's the insects. Let me show you to them. They're on the leaf there. See those? I don't know if they're dying off or what, but that's the insects right there. That's squash bugs. I think they're called squash bugs, squash beetles. That's them right there. I sprayed the crap on them. They were on the other side of the leaf and all that before, and evidently now they're on this side of the leaf. Got squash bugs all over this leaf over here. And the plant looks better than it has for a long time. You can see pods down there look like flowers are going to come out. But like I said, they might be dying off. Hopefully they are. I'm not going to touch them. But I sprayed the crap out of these yesterday. See, this looks like it's dying. That's going to be ripped up. But see, all this was zucchini out here. And over here was watermelon and... cantaloupe. These 2 watermelons over here we pulled up. We're getting so many watermelons we couldn't eat them all. We juiced them. We gave a bunch of them away. Pete, get off the plastic, buddy. Get off the plastic. See, there's a cantaloupe. I replanted one right there. It's 2 weeks old. Like I say, it's the first full week, going into the second week of August right now. We got until October to grow, so we got another 2 months basically. So we'll have another vine, probably about 4 more cantaloupe coming up at least. Yesterday I planted, I think I did 2 seeds maybe of cantaloupe down there. That's a purple hull pea. Planted another one too, right? Oh wait, it's coming up. There's another, the other purple hull pea is coming up over here. Yeah. Here's the other purple hull pea. Now they were planted at the same time. See how that one looks. Look at that one there. That's about 3 inches above the ground. I hear a plane, but I'm looking. I don't see a plane. Yeah, I watch the planes out here all the time. Like I say earlier, My wife made the decision before. Wonder if that was a drone like we saw over here in the sky a couple years ago. January, just dead stopped. It was dead stopped. And like I said, well, I couldn't get it with the video camera at that time, and I didn't even have the crack on the screen like I do now. So that's my reason, not excuse, my reason why a lot of stuff I'm trying to show you is not really coming out, because I can't see it at all. But that's the purple hull pea. That's a purple hull pea there. They were planted at the same time. That's about 3 inches up off the, out of the hull, and this one's just now coming up above the soil. Okay. That's a bean that was growing next to the house. That's another thing. See, we don't even know for sure. We got beans that grow. We drop a bean or something and start growing. That is a bean, though, that was growing up by the house. So, we'll see how that comes. I got closer to this here. We got all this space for them to grow now. I wanted to buy some lattice and 8-foot pieces and have them cut in half so they'd be 4-foot length. They're by 4-foot by 4-foot with sturdy poles to tie them next to, and then separate them about 4 feet with string to connect them to grow on. But yeah, well, you see how that worked. And anyway, this is how empty everything is out here now. That's still got to be pulled out. That's purple pole beans back there. It's all got to be pulled up. The okra, that's still putting out pretty good. Going in there and breaking a lot of the branches. And I pulled them out and put them in the compost because, you know, they should be good for compost. But this is something to pull out every day. We go out here and we pick them when they're about 3 inches or longer. And man, we get a lot. Oh, there's one my wife must have missed this morning, if I can get out of camera now. Where's that? I have to zoom out to try to get into where it's at. Right there, right there. Right there, see that long one there? That's about 4.5-5 inches long. There's another red one. The red ones seem to grow real long. That one there. There's one right there. I think it's right there. I'll cut those off here when I'm done recording. But see, you see insects got all over these too, but they still produce pretty good. Next year, everything, this was a really welcome surprise the way everything came out quite a bit. Next year, if it comes out even half as much as we did this year, we have more than that. We got so much now, it's great. Okra, I was hoping for more purple hull peas and black-eyed peas, although we got a lot of black-eyed peas. But see, those back three stations of black-eyed peas, they've got pods on them and they're still green, but in the middle there, one, two, three, four, almost four stations there. Look at how they almost look dried out and everything. See, this is in the morning, the sun comes over here and gets this part. And then it gets later in the day, it'll start getting the back over there, and then it'll go, and by 1 o'clock, everything out here is in total sun, and it's hot. This plastic helps it grow. But, look at the skies we lost 20, 30 years ago. The shade of blue. And look at the Monsanto corn. You can see it forever. Monsanto, 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 Monsanto. Monsanto corn. And there's another one of the planes up there. They go by. I give them the finger all the time because they're just doing surveying the land and whatnot so they can see what they can go over. And then if we start getting more disease and stuff not growing next year, I'll know. I'm not paranoid, but I'll tell you what. For things to die off as fast as they have, Fukushima and chemtrails. What a great combination. No one will ever suspect it. They'll just think that it's just a freak of nature, or it's disease, or it's this, or it's that. You know, if you don't question everything, you're the idiot. You're the stupid person. But I've got my flowers I'm going to start putting out next year early. I don't know if I'm going to plant them this fall or wait till spring. But these orange torch sunflowers mixed with the yellow ones. See, I got a little place right here. Little place right there. So you got enough room for like 2 to 3 swipes with a lawnmower. And see, with CJ's grave, I don't know if I want to go too close on this side of her grave. I might put just a, you know, from here. I might go from here even and go and connect over there and just get all this all together. But she'll leave right by here from CJ's grave. So another 3 feet, 4 feet from where I left off right there. And then over on this side of her grave, we got a little bit of star right there. It's a little hump here too that goes there. But I'm gonna go here and I might come up to about here. So I got another 4 feet over here to get closer to the grave and put these flowers here. So we'll have them here, right there, over there, and then you see that string in the distance there. Where is it? I can't. There's a string over there somewhere. I'm going about 14 feet there. I'm gonna leave a break and then I'm gonna go 14 feet again and then another break and some more. And it'll have a mixture of these orange torch and their yellow sunflowers. Oh, God. So, that's the garden. Alrighty.